hive! It's a rack hive!
This is not awesome!
Freeze!
Neither end of this car is in a good situation, but you guys have decided that being able to drive this thing in the first place is top priority.
Help, Reese! I'll cover the back! Come on! Get off of me!
Bring it on!
Hey! A little help?
You ugly piece of... Into my mouth! I got it in my mouth!
Rack hives are actually a boss-type enemy in earlier Borderlands games. There's a few in the first Borderlands, but only one that I can remember in Borderlands 2 as part of the Captain Scarlet DLC. Most notably, they spawn tons and tons of Rack, which are the flying monsters attacking us. But they also have a pooping attack. I really hope that isn't going to happen to our friends here. I fucking love that title sequence. It's probably my favorite of the bunch. It's the moment that really sold me on how awesome this game was, and when I first saw it, I started furiously mashing the screenshot button. Now, while I personally am having tons of fun, I wonder how Reese and Vaughn feel about the situation.
The list of things that might kill us keeps getting longer. I hadn't even thought about moonshots. Racks, skags, bandits, dehydration, heat stroke, regular stroke, stroke. Whatever that is. That murder pile. The list just keeps getting longer. I've never felt so alive!
This is awesome! I can't imagine going back to financial reports. Ugh, boring.
That's the spirit, buddy.
It's just... I know it's weird to say, but I'm having a great time.
Vaughn, I feel the same way.
This is what I'm talking about! Mixing it up with Hyperion, teaming up with grifters? Come on, these are the types of stories we'll tell our children when we're millionaires. We just survived moonshots from Hyperion, huh? Friggin' moonshots, man! I am not afraid anymore! You hear me, Hyperion? I am Vaughn, and I am not afraid! Yo, what the hell was that?
Relax, it's a vet.
Oh, okay. I have to pee. And not because I was scared. I had to go anyway.
This is perfect timing.
Freeze, you're alive. Thank God you guys are okay. I thought that was it for a second there. I am so relieved.
So, thanks for the warning.
Trust me, I tried. I did.
Tell her to send some supplies!
Yeah, don't talk to me while you're peeing. Thank you.
Sorry! Almost done!
Anyway, I got them to stop shooting, but I can't keep Vasquez from wanting to take you guys out. I'm doing what I can, but it's chaos up here. So I can't talk long.
Vaughn is requesting supplies. Oh, and we're stranded out here in the desert.
Look, I'm able to track you, so stay safe for now. I'll send what I can.
Cool.
Hopefully she can help us out. We can't be walking through the desert too long. I mean, not without water. Go through all this and die of dehydration would be pretty lame.
Vaughn? Did you get stung by bees?
What? Why? What's happening?
'Cause you're looking all swole.
Huh?
Swollen. Swole is short for swollen. You are weirdly buff, dude. That's what I'm...
I put an exercise bike in my office a few months ago. Don't worry about it.
Right.
He is pretty young. I gotta say, I'm a little envious of the definition he's got going. Saving the world, it doesn't leave you much time for the gym. I mean, I've got muscles where it matters, sure, but, damn, I could never get that tone.
Would you stop sneaking up on me?
Who's sneaking? I don't sneak.
Oh, so you've been here this whole time?
Yeah.
Oh.
Reese, who are you talking to?
I asked earlier in the thread how comfortable you would be telling other people that Handsome Jack is in our brain. Would people think we're crazy? Lying? You guys decided, for now, it would be okay to at least tell our best buddy Vaughn.
Is this some kind of post-concussion thing?
So, and I know this sounds nuts, but... I'm talking to Handsome Jack. Yeah, he's in my head. Or something. I can see him. He's standing right next to you. But you... obviously, can't see him.
Right. Right. So, Handsome Jack is standing next to me.
Yes.
And I can't see him, but you're able to see him and also talk to him.
Correct.
He definitely thinks you're crazy. Who exactly is this little muscle-bound tool?
Vaughn. You believe me, right?
Reese! Oh, I'm late for my tea time!
Shut up! No, not you. Sorry.
Okay. Ask him how many fingers I'm holding up.
I don't know. He's scratching his ass, and, Oh! God, I think he may have pissed on his shirt. That's not
clean. Yeah, how many?
Three.
You're holding up three fingers.
Lucky guess.
You know it's not. Come on, we should get out of the sun.
I don't understand.
join the club. Jinx.
Let's go.
I can't tell if I'm crazy or you're crazy.
Something you've probably noticed is how childish Handsome Jack is. This isn't a faulty AI or anything, that's just how Jack is. One of the earliest lines of dialogue he has in Borderlands 2 is, he calls you to brag that he has a pony made of diamonds. He named it Butt Stallion.
Yeah, what do you mean?
Well, I mean, of all the people in the universe Handsome Jack could be appearing to, it just happens to be the guy who's totally obsessed with him. I mean, it's crazy! It's like destiny.
What? Should I be creeped out right now? Because I'm feeling a little creeped out.
What? No, I wouldn't say I'm, you know, obsessed. I admire his work, sure, but I mean, obsessed? That's a strong way to
describe it. Take it down a couple of notches, kiddo. I'm really digging how you're looking at me right now.
I'm not sure it is.
I mean, think about it.
You got all those Handsome Jack posters in your office, dude. I think that's a little weird.
That makes two of us.
Yeah, those are motivational posters. You know, like the cat, dang it. They're Hyperion issued.
Well, maybe it has something to do with the Nakayama drive.
Namayaka, what? Why does that sound familiar?
No, I did shove a bunch of data, you know, straight into my head.
Nakayama, right, the weirdo that was obsessed with me. The other weirdo that was obsessed with me.
I'm not obsessed.
Oh, man. Hyperion would kill to get their hands on this.
This?
You! Your head or body or whatever Jack is in.
Yeah, they would, wouldn't they?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I'm okay with telling Vaughn, but we really don't need more reasons to be on Hyperion's shit list. For now, let's keep mum until we can assess the situation.
We don't tell anyone. Not at least until we figure out
what No. You need to get me back to Helios.
You're probably right.
No. You are definitely wrong. This is torture. That's what it is. I'm in hell. This is what hell is.
It's about time.
There.
Hopefully she included some water.
Uh-oh. Incoming!
It's coming right for us.
Hey, I guess that tracker's working, huh, boys?
It's coming right for us!
Come to Papa!
Nice sock.
Fancy meeting you two here. Here I was, out for a nice drive, and I land right on just the guys I was looking for.
It's red, Hugo. I thought you wanted your car in black.
Ho ho ho. I see what you did there. That's funny. You steal my car, you make jokes about it. That's good. That's great stuff. Look, I know we had a deal. And while I don't like to go back on an agreement made man to man, the circumstances have changed.
Hey, that's right. We did have a deal. You convinced me to double-cross my best friend, and the day isn't even over before you're double-crossing me?
Oh. Oh, man. When you put it like that, it does sound awful.
What?
Should've known better than to trust a snake like you.
Oh, don't be like that, little guy. It's just the way of the, Listen, I'm gonna go see if I got a shirt in the trunk, because your body is making me uncomfortable. Hold tight, kids.
Look, I told him I would sell you out, but I swear I wasn't gonna do it. I was just saying whatever he wanted to hear just to keep that jerk off our backs. I wasn't gonna follow through with it. Please believe me. I swear, Reese. I would
We will talk about this later.
Okay.
This is something we'll deal with next video, but tell me, do you trust Vaughn? Do you think he'd actually betray us?
What's that?
They're shovels, genius. You two freaks start digging. I want to see a decent grave going before too long. You heard me. Don't make me tell you again.
No. I'm not digging.
How about I gutshot you? Your little friend can watch you bleed out.
I do not want to do that.
What a good friend. What part of dig don't you understand? Let's get going, Mr. Universe.
Okay, just don't shoot.
There you go. A little hard work never killed anybody. I mean, you're gonna die. Yeah, sure. But I mean, it won't be the hard work.
We could comply and dig our own grave, but hey, I mean, if he's gonna kill us regardless, we might as well go down swinging.
To be fair, that was supposed to hit you.
Wait.
Wait!
Oh. Damn. Damn, that smarts. I think I did that wrong. You got a tough noggin. Looks so easy in the movies, but...
Amateur hour. You gotta aim for the bridge of the nose, dum-dum.
How is it every time I show up, you idiots are in a worse situation?
You're not helping.
All right, fun's over. Looks like we'll be settling for the shallow variety of grave. Reese, you die first, and then he can load your body in the car. I'll bury Vaughn myself.
What?
Yeah, they want this idiot's body for something up there. Something, important floating around in his head. This is a prototype. The most advanced gun Hyperion has ever made.
Someone's overcompensating.
Any last words before the, what is it, with the inevitable end of, gosh, damn this thing, it's, what the hell?
Two, eat shit.
Yeah, there's the spirit. Well, that was three words, but I'll be sure to put eat shit on your tombstone.
And I'd be more worried about my tombstone if you knew where the safety was.
You're hilarious. I'm gonna miss your...
Gosh damn it. Is there a problem?
Yeah, I know how to shoot a gun. I just want to get the maximum damage out of this thing.
Okay, look. As much as I'd love to watch this idiot kill you two idiots, I can't let that happen. I'm not inside you, but I'm like, look, if you go, I go. I've enhanced your Echo Eye, so use it to hack something and get us the hell out of this jam. Figure out how you can pay me back later. I've got you back. Right. Okay, mess this guy up.
Hey, all right. Genius programmer Handsome Jack has given us a few upgrades. We could try hacking Vasquez's gun, but the last thing I want to do is accidentally activate that thing. So let's see what we can do with the car.
Button on a gun.
Your subsystem access, that's new.
Just saying, nothing's happening.
Maybe we could try honking the horn a little bit, see if we can distract Vasquez.
Safety on this fuck. Surprise! What the hell's going on? Just safety.
That got to him a bit, but didn't quite do the trick. Okay. What if we turned on the radio?
Check. Ammo. Check. Whoa! Did you do that?
And paranoia! It begins.
Well, there's only one thing left to futz around with in here. Let's try revving up the engine a bit and see what this bad boy can do.
I cannot be the first person to shoot.
What are you doing with your hands?
I'm not doing that.
Oh, hello. This is an interesting little development.
Fine, look, we gotta go. This is my head! Get out!
Oh, come on, don't be like that.
Oh!
Oh, easy what you did. Easy.
Reese!
Yeah, go ahead and run. You're just making this butter for me. I'm gonna kill you!
Loader bot! Yes! event wouldn't let us down!
I missed you.
I missed you more.
This isn't over! You hear me? You hear me?
So should we be going to Hollow Point or straight to Old Haven? I mean, they know where we're going. Maybe we should just meet them there.
Well, I guess we could just meet them in Old Haven and get a head start. Or we could always just go to Hollow Point, though that might be dangerous. Man, this is a big decision. It's weird, but I always, talk to myself during, huge choices. It's just something I do when I know it's just, super important. I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to me right now. So, anywho, probably should just choose something.
And so we have a big decision. Where should the boys fly off to?
Well, that's probably enough out of me.
They could go to Old Haven to get a head start. The girls know that's where our goal is, and they'll likely eventually meet us there. However, we don't know what's waiting for us, and it could be dangerous to go alone. We could instead go to Hollow Point and regroup with the girls. It would boost team trust a bit, but there's a chance that maybe they've already left by the time we get there. Also, bringing two Hyperion suits into another bandit town could be asking for trouble. Where would you guys like to go? The choice is yours.